Hi, in the closet today is not coming to you from my closet because I've just returned from the Christmas break. I'm half unpacked, my wardrobe's a mess, and nobody needs to see that. So we're in my dining room today. Anyway, what I wanted to talk to you about today is the charity bin model, because all is not as it seems. And from a social and environmental perspective, where our clothing ends up is as important as where it comes from. So I thought I'd shed some light on that today. So what happens when we put our used clothing into these charity bins that we see all over the place is that the clothing is collected, it's aggregated, and then about the top 30%, the cream of the crop, is retained on shore and sold through secondhand clothing stores. The other 70-75% is on-sold to developing countries. So it's not donated, it doesn't go to those less fortunate than ourselves in some sort of charitable model. It is on-sold. And the developing nations where it goes, they buy the clothing in closed bales. So they can't see what is in them. They can price slightly higher price and have them opened, but the margins are so small that they buy them closed bales, they open them up, they retrieve what they can on sell, and generally the rest of it is dumped. And this has a significant environmental impact, and you just need to Google something like the Uke Uke Mountains in the Philippines, and probably saying this completely wrong, but if you Google UKAY mountains, it will show you these mountains of clothing in the Philippines that are just vast, and they're waste clothing that is rotting in the elements. So it is certainly not ideal. From Australia, New Zealand, our clothing goes into the Pacific region, and New Zealand's exports and used clothing to Papua New Guinea alone last year valued about $14 million. So when we think that we're putting our clothing into these bins, thinking that they're actually going to those less fortunate or the value is going to the charities, that is not exactly what is happening. The charities receive a tiny percentage of the value of those clothing, but what we're actually doing is providing free stock for multi-million dollar private businesses. So from New Zealand, ours go to the Pacific. From UK, US and Europe, most of their clothing goes into Africa. And what has happened recently is the Eastern Bloc of African countries proposed a ban of the importation of secondhand clothing, because what it has done is it's decimated the local clothing and textile industry, because the prices are so low, it's undercutting the industry. And so these highly skilled jobs are lost, and people end up trading in clothing, in cheap used clothing. So that has big economic implications, social implications, and also because of the dumping of the clothes, it has environmental implications as well. So when this block of countries proposed this ban, the response from the very powerful US rag traders was to lobby Washington and have the trade deal between Africa and the US rescinded. And to that, to the African countries, this has significant economic impact. So several of the countries pulled back from the ban on secondhand clothing, and what happens is this allows the US to continue to dump the used clothing into Africa. So if this is not a model that you want to support, then there are alternatives. Number one, if you want the full value of the clothing to go to a charity, then there are a number of charities that resell themselves. So if you donate directly to St. Vincent de Paul's, to Red Cross, to Salvation Army, they all have stores that they can on sell it to their customers. So that's number one. Number two is buy the best quality clothing that you can, and then it will last longer, it will look really great, and also if you really invest in your clothing, people tend to take a lot better care of it. So the whole process is slowed down, so we don't sort of literally rip through our clothing. The next thing you can do is you can swap your clothing with your friends and family. You can trade your clothing yourselves online, and then if you wish to donate to a charity, you can use some of the money that you get back from those trades to donate to a charity. If your clothes are really degraded, nobody wants them. So the best thing that you can do is to use them yourself. So cotton's really great as cleaning rags. You can use all of your clothing as fillers and things like cushions, draft stops, bean bags, and pet cushions. So there's a number of things that you can use your used clothing within. So I hope this has been helpful and provide a little clarity on that model. And coming up in 2018 and in the closet, we're interviewing a number of really interesting people, from designers to activists. So I hope you'll join us. Thanks.